singing something, but said, yeah, like a fun.
So, okay, I gave everybody chances to think about their decision. Trying to be nice, trying to play. Sometimes it just don't work though, you know what I mean? Here, give me that, give me that. Can you get that water for me? Thank you so much, sir.
Connected. Yeah. Thank you. Love is patient, it is kind, it is also not self-seeking, is not easily angry, it keeps no records of wrong. Love never dies. I'm reminded of a mother's love, which resembles the love of God, unconditional and everlasting, straight from the heart, bearing the strength of a lioness, watching over her cubs, guided by heavenly source. May the memories of your mother's love, Miss Christine Shaw, my friend, continue to make you strong as you allow her love to carry on long after she is gone and pass on through the lives of your little one and to the family. Please be reminded that song of that song, and this is dedicated to the family. For your hands shall send forth comfort in the storm, casting out fear from their hearts. They shall find rest in thee as you grant them thy increase. Never lonely shall they be, content always, even in times of grief. Your spirit resting and abiding, eliminating sorrow, replacing it with peace, with hearts renewed, trusting in you, praising you for all you do in spirit and in truth, worshiping only you, even when skies are blue, in the midst of grief and sorrow, bringing them hope for tomorrow. For weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning light. In the midst of all our mourning, we surrender all to you. God, you are good. Your love and mercy forever endures, granting us great strength to move on. Thanks to your peace granted to us in the midst of the storm.
We will have the word of comfort, and then we want to listen. We will be listening to this. Something about the name Jesus. Something about his name. His name. Not our name, but his name. I last saw Miss Kristen at Walmart. Then I saw her there and I heard, hello. My sister said, that sounds like Helen. Because we was on another aisle. And I said, no. Well, it was him. And her mom. And I heard this, hello. And she walked down and she gave me a hug. That was her. That's who I knew. That's who I knew when I would see her. So today is one of those days where you want to lift up everyone. You want to lift them up. You want to lift up the family. But you also have to say the right thing. Why do you need lifting up on a day when your heart is broken? Why do people try to lift you up and get you to smile and get you to think? And you go, I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. This is my mom. This is my brother. This And someone is always trying to get you to laugh and just say, it'll be okay. But in our hearts, we'll say, it's not okay right now. Let me cry. Let me ask those questions. In my heart, those things come out. This is why. It's okay. It is okay. It is okay that your baby just did the most wonderful thing, is to hug you and do you like this. It's okay. Now, what can you take from that love? What can you take from that love that your baby just did to you, that you did to your mom? Your memories. This little one, I was watching Grayson and he was hugging mommy and he was doing like this. One thing about death is this. The Bible says it is the last enemy to be defeated. But why do we say we defeat death when we don't see the person anymore? Why do we say that? Because Satan thinks he has taken your love for everyone that you had any feeling about. He thinks he's just taken away from you. He thinks you can't go on. He thinks you'll just blame God and turn around and not want to care about anybody. But he's wrong. He's wrong when you let him be wrong. He is wrong because out of death can come the precious love that Jesus has for you and you and you and you and you. Just like Grayson just said. He's doing that to you. He will do that just like that baby. He loves you. But most of all, he wants you to love him. Most of all. You know, when we... I'm going to go to Psalm 31. And I want you to just listen to this. In Psalm 30, the Bible says, sing praise to the Lord, you saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holy name. For his anger is but for a moment. His favor is for life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. And what is that joy? And where is the morning time? Not the next day. Where is the joy? How can you pick up the joy? How can you do that here? God's word says this. This is still chapter 30, verse 8. This is Psalm. He says, David is doing this. David says, I cried out to you, O Lord, and to the Lord I made supplication. What profit is there in my blood when I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you? Will it declare your truth? Hear, O Lord, and have mercy on me. Lord, be my helper. And if we can go right back over here and say this one thing, and I want to tell it to you, family and friends. He says, David said, I cried out to you. I cried out to you. We cry out to God. Sometimes we just sit on the edge of the bed or wherever we are. And we just think about those things. what does the word say? Hear, O Lord, and have mercy on me. Lord, be my help. That's all I'm going to say. Help me. Help me. You see, we sometimes think that, God, I've done this, I've done that, I've thought this, I've messed up here. Because see, that's what death does. Sometimes death talks to you. And how is that? You see the loved one. You'll go, if only I had done this, or only if I had done that. If only, if only, if only. And this is what Satan wants you to do. He wants you to get in the if only. He doesn't want you to see that death has overcome. If you are God's child, that's the last enemy to be defeated. And then we'll go on and we'll say, oh, this, maybe I should have done, maybe I shouldn't have done this, but listen to this. I want you to listen to this very closely. In Psalm 27, verse 12. I want you to hear this. Helen, I want you to hear this. Jerome, I want you to hear this. He says, I would have lost heart, David said, unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Here. I would have lost heart unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And what this is saying, friends and family, is this. He wants you, the main enemy, Satan. He wants you to now say, well, I should have done, I should have, could have, would have. I did, well, maybe I should have done more of this, or maybe that, or maybe I should have done this. God says, the only thing that you need to do is to see my goodness here in the land of the living. Be strengthened here. Be strengthened here. It's okay to cry. You got to do that. But then, you know how you can raise yourself up and just have feel him doing this in your heart? Feel God. Feel Jesus, the love of Jesus in your heart. He said, okay, Helen. She said, yes. What has he shown you in the land of the living? What's the goodness? See, when you can look and see his goodness, in spite of all the mess, in spite of all the chaos, in spite of the hurt, when you can still see some goodness, God, you showed me that, no matter what it is. Your faith will be lifted. Glory. Your faith will be lifted. No matter what's going on, your faith. The word says, David says, I would have lost heart unless I had believed. The only thing you got to do is believe. Believe that Jesus is who he says he is. Believe. And when those things come, memories come that shouldn't be and want to torment you, guess what? Oh, wait a minute. I got food to eat today. Oh, wait a minute. I just gotta come. you may have will be defeated by the joy that can come in your heart. By seeing God do wonderful things in your life, in the land of the living. Amen. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you for strengthening this family. We thank you for strengthening friends so that they can be able, Lord, to say, I see you coming in the name of the Lord. Amen, 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 amen. We'll listen to our song, something about the name Jesus, and as we listen, we can proceed to have the recessional, and God bless you. God bless you, fam. I say fam because that's what you are. And y'all say, you fam too. Couture. See, that's how long I've been gone. They do. Amen. Okay, let's listen to the words and you all can be dismissed. As you listen.
Hallelujah. Young people, there's nothing wrong with dancing for Jesus. We can't forget where we come from. So come on, let's have a little church right now.
Something about that name.
and Sun Mortuary would like to thank the family of Mrs. Christine Shaw for trusting us with your loved one. We certainly hope someone has said something to you or done something for you just to make your grief a little easier to bear. We know your hearts are heavy today. We know there's going to be a great adjustment and some very, very lonesome days without Mrs. Shaw. We will continue to remember you in our prayers. Thank you.
Thank you.